thank you so much for being here. You have come for a great purpose to start off this school year. We're asking God certainly to intervene in all aspects of the school and all aspects of our community. On behalf of the Hohenwald Church of Christ and the Lewis County Churches Coalition, we welcome you. Thank you so much for all of those who have been a part in the planning and preparation for this, whether you're a member of whichever body you normally worship with. And we're just tickled that you could be here tonight. And despite our differences, we've come together tonight to celebrate our Savior, the one and only Son of God, Jesus Christ. And we just pray that this will be an event that God will be listening to all of our prayers individually and corporately tonight. As we begin, I want to give a special thanks to David Grimes, who I would have not been able to plan all this without his help. He's been especially helpful. A number of others have too. And those who have helped to prepare the building and the food and things like that, we want to thank all of you as well. Those running the PA, Lindsay, we couldn't do a whole lot of things without you. As we begin tonight, we will ask those who are going to be praying, leading, singing to use this lower microphone. I just thought I could get your attention better from here. So thank you for your participation tonight. May God bless our service together. I wanted to begin, before Steve leads us in song, with a verse we studied last night on Sunday night class. And it's from Ephesians chapter 4, beginning in verse 2. Be completely humble and gentle. Be patient, bearing with one another in love. Make every effort to keep the unity of the Spirit through the bond of peace. There is one body and one Spirit, just as you were called to one hope when you were called. One Lord, one faith, one baptism, one God and Father of all, who is over all and through all and in all. Brother Steve?
Let's sing these two songs and then Brother Bill Webb will lead us in our opening prayer.
Praise God from
God. 58 years ago, my wife and I were joined together right here, where I'm standing, in matrimony. But tonight we've got even a great, great occasion to join together with Christians, ministers, Christians from different congregations, different places across our county. And it's an honor to be here tonight. I want to pray tonight for the administration of the school and school board. So let us bow in prayer. Heavenly Father, we come to you tonight in the great and wonderful name of Jesus Christ. We come to you because we know that you are the only true and living God. And we know that your word says that your eyes go to and fro throughout the face of the whole earth to prove yourself strong on behalf of those whose heart is perfect towards you. We gather here tonight in unity and oneness, in faith and prayer. We come to pray for our school system. I was thinking, Lord, as I drove up here tonight, that the Bible says, blessed is the nation whose God is the Lord. And I think that applies. We could aptly say tonight, blessed is the school system or any other organization whose God is the Lord. And so we come to you tonight and we ask you to bless this coming year, these administrators, the school board, that they do such a good job and sacrifice many hours to take care of our children, our grandchildren, our great-grandchildren. We're so thankful for them tonight. And I ask you to, as this year goes, starts and goes on in the school year, that you will give them wisdom and knowledge to do what they need to do and help to train our children up in the way they need to be trained up, Lord. We thank you for every one of them. We ask you to bless them and their families, and we ask you to give them wisdom and help them, Lord, to lead these many people in all of our school systems here, each school system, each place, each department. We ask you to bless them and help them more than anything to lead by example as a child of God. In Jesus' name we pray. Amen.
Good evening. What a beautiful sight this is.
Y'all, I never in my life thought I would be able to be such a part of such something so neat, the unity of the body of Christ. We're going to sing two songs, and after we sing, Brother Chris Bean is going to come up and pray for us. So if you would, please all let's stand.
Jesus, we adore you.
Right.
I've been tasked to pray for the parents. We got any parents in here? Got a couple? You know, when Brother Rick called, I thought about this a lot, and I come up with a couple of scriptures I'd like to share with you first, too. And, you know, I want to charge us as parents to be leaders of our homes, to show our children the way that they should go. Proverbs 22:6 says, train up a child in the way he should go, and when he's old, he will not depart from it. And also, I also wrote down Ephesians chapter 6 and verse 4. It says, and you fathers, I think I should, that could very well be parents just as well as it is fathers. But do not provoke your children to anger or to wrath. Bring them up in the nurture and the admonition of the Lord. I also got it down in the New Living Translation, and I like the way that it reads as well, but it says, fathers, do not provoke your children to anger by the way that you treat them. Rather, bring them up in with the discipline and instruction that comes from the Lord. You know, we need direction just as much as they do, don't we? So let's pray. Dear Heavenly Father, I thank you for this day, Lord. I thank you for this opportunity, and we thank you for the ability to be able to gather together, Lord, and under your name, Father, and that we want to pray that you just touch the parents today, Lord, that you would divinely lead them and guide them and direct them, Lord. Help them to be the leaders of their home as you've called us to be, Father. And we just pray that as your presence moves us, Lord, that we would go about our daily walk to lead our children in your way, Father. We pray that you would touch the parents as they carry their children to school and from school, Lord. And be with them as they travel to the ball games, to all the events, Lord, that they have. And we pray that you would lead them in their homes, Lord, in every way, not only for the parents, Lord, but for the grandparents and those others that are leading, that have stepped up and took the role of parents for these children, Lord. We pray that you just divinely lead us and guide us and direct us through our days, through this coming year, Lord. We pray our hedge of protection around the homes of the families, Lord. Help fathers to stand up and be fathers and leaders of their home, Lord. Help the mothers to take their position as well, Father. And I just pray for all the single parents, Lord, as well, that you would move upon them. But we pray first and foremost that if there's any parents in our that belong to the children in this school, Lord, if they don't know you, that your mighty hand would move upon them, Lord, that conviction would grip their hearts, Lord, and they would take their position as being a godly parent in this county, in this school system, Lord. Just move upon them that in such a way that they might all have parents that know you, Lord. And we just want to thank you and praise you and honor you for all that you do. In your mighty name we pray. Amen.
After this song, we'll have Brother Felix Gomez have our prayer. If you would, please stand.
In need of strength, in need of peace, in need of faith. afternoon. Man, I tell you what, this is awesome. When I look outside out here and what we have been experiencing here lately, here in Honewall, it brings great joy to my heart. Because we're accomplishing here what chapter 17 is talking about. That is the Lord's Prayer. When the Lord prayed to his Heavenly Father, that we would become one as he and the Father are one. Because when we become one, we have that little faith of a mustard seed. That when we tell that mountain to move, that mountain will move. Amen. So it gives me great honor to be here this evening and be able to pray for the support staff in our schools. These are people that sometimes are unseen. So let's go to the Heavenly Father in prayer. Father God, we thank you so much for this unity, Lord. We come together under one headship, under one lordship. We are blessed. We thank you, Father, for the support team, that for the schools, Lord. We pray for the security officers that are keeping our schools safe and our children safe. We pray for our kitchen staff that feed our children, Lord. They have a rough job because a lot of times they don't like the food, but they have to do what they have to do, Lord. We pray also, Lord, for the janitors, Lord, that keep our schools clean. A lot of times they don't want to do it, but that's what they're called to do, Lord. It takes a special person to do their job, Lord. And so, Lord, we pray also, Lord, for the teacher's aides, that sometimes they have to take a child and just teach them one-on-one, Lord. We pray also, Lord, for the school bus drivers, Father. These people have a tough job. They have a job that not only concentrating on the road, but also the children that they're carrying, Lord. Sometimes they don't get along with each other. And, Lord, I just pray, Lord, that you give them the peace that they need, the words to say, because these people, Lord, the crossing guards, even, Lord, that they come out during and rain and the heat of the day, Lord, and when it's cold, Father, all these people, Father, let them be the ones who you bless their homes, first of all, Father. Take care of them, Lord. Because when their home is run good and they're running a good ship there, Lord, they can come to work with a joyful heart. And they'd be able to talk to our children, Lord. Be the first, sometimes they're the first ones that our child sees, Father. And sometimes they have problems. So, Lord, I ask, Lord, that you give them the strength that they need. That you give them the words that they need to speak, Father, when they're speaking to our children, Lord. I pray for them, Lord. I lift them up to you, Father. And I ask, Lord, that you protect in each and every one of them, Father. And I also pray, Lord, if any one of these folks, Lord, does not know you, Father, I ask, Lord, that you just bring them and share, someone would share the gospel to them. Maybe it'd be one of our children, Lord. That'd be a great thing to see, Father. We thank you, Lord, for these people. We love you, Lord, and we ask all of this in your name, Jesus. Amen. Amen.
So if you'll stand with me again, please. We're going to have two songs here, and then Mark Whitehead from the Grace Fellowship Church will lead a prayer for our teachers. There is an
many teachers do we have here tonight? Just see some hands. Okay, thank you. Thank you so much for what you do. I'll tell you, I've always respected teachers, but then all of a sudden, last year, my wife became a teacher, and it was something that God did, and now I have even more respect for teachers. But thank you so much. Let's pray. Father, this is an incredible night. I thank you for a community that comes together and supports our schools and our teachers and our students. But right now, we turn our eyes to the teachers, God. I thank you so much for blessing us with so many incredible teachers here. And it's not just that they know a lot or that they're great at their job. They are, but God, it's more than that. So many love you. So many know you. So many love their students. And I just thank you for this community and for these teachers that we have here. You have blessed us tremendously, God. And I know being a teacher is truly a calling. I've seen that in my own family. It is a calling from you. And it's not always easy. But God, in those moments when it's not easy and our teachers are struggling, I just pray that you would remind them that you're the one that called them to it and that you have never left them, you have never forsaken them, you are with them. God, I thank you so much for those teachers. And I pray, God, that they would see their students with the same vision you see them. God, that each student that you have blessed them with was created in your image. And supernaturally, God, give them that in their heart, that they truly see every boy and every girl in our students, in our system, was created by you and you love them, and give them a love for their students, Father. I pray for those hard days where they need an extra dose of patience, an extra dose of grace, that you would give it to them. But God, more than anything tonight, my prayer for our teachers is this, that their walk with you would be sweet, that their relationship with you would be stronger than it's ever been this year. God, that you would draw them unto yourself, that they would wake up in the morning longing to spend time with you, spend time in your word, spend time praying. And Father, that love for you would overflow as they teach. And they would teach more than just lessons, but they would teach students and they would pour into them like so many teachers have done to my kids. Father, that I pray that that love and that spiritual longing for you would overflow into our students, and that you would do something special in this school year in our schools. May it start with our teachers that are in love with you. So, Father, we look to you this school year. I pray for an amazing year with our teachers, and I just look forward to what you're going to do. In Jesus' name we pray all these things. Amen.
Let's all stand. You nailed it. What you said was perfect. The unity of the body of Christ, regardless of the sign over the door. We're going to sing two songs, and after we finish these songs, very pillar of our community, Brother
3 years ago, my wife and I came to live in Hohenwald, Tennessee. And all I can say is it's wonderful. To God be the glory. I believe this will be our last dwelling place after our moves with the Methodist. I've been the ecumenical brother here. I started out in the United Methodist Church and made my way to Full Gospel Church and then finally into the Assemblies of God. Went to New Orleans Baptist Theological Seminary. Went to Bellhaven College Presbyterian. So if I'm the one person here that can be in unity. I know God is so good and he's so faithful. Amen. My wife is a school teacher, retired now, in Clark Range High School, Fentress County, on the plateau. My son-in-law, Brent Hogan, who's married to my daughter and have two beautiful children, live in Russellville, Arkansas. He's an English professor at Arkansas Tech University. Jesus laid the foundation for teaching. He taught those disciples. Hope Ministries, disciples. We counsel. We lead. By the help of the Holy Spirit, with the Lord Jesus in our hearts and with us. Teaching is a foundation. I've been asked to do the college students and the graduates. And you know, we'll have many young people that have graduated. This year has been their year of graduation. Next year they're facing college. Some will be going off far away from home, some of them just to Columbia State. But they're going off, they're going into a new realm. They're leaving that protection and covering of a family. They're walking out of those doors and they're going out into the real world. And the foundation that parents, Chris prayed for the parents, the foundations that we have laid for our children is what they will take out there with them. And we pray that greatest foundation is Jesus Christ. Amen. Because if they know him, they can make it through. Amen. All the fiery darts of the devil against them, they can make it through and stand firm in a knowledge and a faith in Jesus Christ. Amen. Let's bow our heads and pray. Lord God, we pray for our college students. We pray, God, that those that graduated high school, as they enter into these years of college, some won't go, but God, you have a very great purpose for their lives. And we ask for your leading and anointing upon each of them. Lord, I pray that those that go off to college, they would find a great church. And Lord God, that you would lead them and bless them, that they would stay with the young people who are like spirit and have faith in the Lord. And God, also that they would pick their friends wisely with wisdom. And Lord, that wouldn't lead them astray into different things that they don't need to be in, but God would to stay a true and faithful course. And also, Lord Jesus, that they would learn discipline. They would learn to tell the devil and the world no, and be able to say it strongly through faith and trust and love in Jesus. And Lord, I thank you for another man in our community who means a lot to me, to our families, and that's Brother Jimmy Jowers and Kathy. Lord, Jimmy with the FCA and what they're doing on the high school campus and what they're doing in the colleges as well. And Lord God, I just pray that you would bless him and anoint him. Lord, all the pastors that are here, to God be the glory for the churches coming together. And Lord, we've desired to see that for many years. And Lord, now to see it and witness it, it's such a blessing. And we give you all the honor, all the praise, and all the glory. In Jesus' name, amen. 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 Praise God. Praise God.
I got to follow that. Wow, brother. I mean, we'll just let him come back up here. I'm sure he can do anything he wants to. No, after after these next two songs, I was sitting here listening and getting all jacked up. And I forgot who I was supposed to announce as praying. But then I looked and I saw his name. And I don't know him by that name. This young man is going to come up and pray just a few minutes. I grew up with him. I grew up with him in the church with his mother. His mother, to me, was one of the pillars of our church. Even though she didn't think she was, she'd tell you she didn't think she was. And she'd tell you what she thought about you, too. But she told you out of love. She loved you. And exactly what Brother just talked about, if your parents put it in their heart when you're young, yeah, you're going to make mistakes. Yeah, you might stray. But look where you're at right now. Look where we're at right now. We've all fallen short. And by the grace of God, by the grace of God, we've all touched each other's lives in some way, shape, form, or fashion. And it's so wonderful that we've been able to come together and sing these songs and hear a wonderful sermon. Just wow. And I've got to follow that. Here we go.
Wonderful, merciful Savior.
You are the one that we brother. But I do, I love you. It's an honor to be here. It's an honor to be asked to do this. Of course, it all, you know, I always find myself out of my comfort zone. But when somebody asks me to do something for God, I'm just not going to say no. And I love our kids also. We had an awesome event last night for our youth. And just unity and love. And I have to agree with Brother Charlie Brewer. He said, you know, our youth is our future. And if we don't teach them about Jesus, then we know who's going to educate them. And we definitely don't want that. Amen. So if you would, just bow with me, please. Lord Jesus, I thank you for the support and unity and love that's being shown here tonight. I pray for the safety of all of our kids this year. I pray that Satan is kept at bay. I ask you, Lord, to send your warring angels to keep a hedge of protection around all our kids and to guide, guard, and direct every step they take this year. I pray and rebuke this woke agenda off all our kids, Lord Jesus. Keep all our kids healthy this year. I pray that you would put in them wisdom and knowledge and patience and most of all love, Lord. I pray that you would put in them a want to have relationship with you and to let them know that you will always be there for them and that you will never leave them, Lord. I pray that you will bless all of our kids in all areas this year, Lord. And I pray that all the students that is of age will come to know you as their Lord and Savior. And I ask all of this in your mighty, precious name. Amen.
Amen.
See, I get to follow everybody. Thank y'all so much for being here tonight with us at Homewall. We're thankful that you're here. We're thankful for the community coming together and all the beautiful prayers. Thankful for all the people who speak God's word. You know, the problem, and it's been mentioned several times, Stig just mentioned it, we got to train our kids. You know, it's very important that our kids get education. It's important that they learn how to do math. It's important that they learn how to do English and all that stuff. But what's more important? Because all that stuff is only temporary. It's only for a short period of time, and then all of a sudden it's gone. Definitely tonight, as we come to the end of this service, we're thankful that you're here again. We're thankful that for the prayers that's been uplifted for our school and our system. Thankful for our students, and thankful for all the other ones that have been mentioned. We encourage you tonight, if you can, to stay with us. We got some refreshments over in the fellowship hall. We would love to have you stay with us. I had some things prepared I was going to say tonight, and after being here, I've kind of changed my mind on several of those things. But definitely, y'all, to be able to see this many people here, and people from everywhere, and people that at this time, wherever your journey is, your Christian journey, it may be very difficult. Guess what? It don't get any easier. At times, it's tough. Christ said it was a straight and narrow way that leads unto life, and few there will be that find it. But as long as you're putting Him first, as long as you're striving to be His, and as long as you are learning this book, this is the book that matters. Now, again, not taking anything away from the school system because it's very important, but this is a book that has eternal consequences. If you don't know Jesus as your Savior, if you've never been obedient to Him, don't put that off. I talk to people a lot and they'll say, well, yeah, I'm waiting until I'm a better person, or I'm waiting until I'm a better human. Well, good luck with that, because that's probably not going to happen. But let God change who you are. Let His Word change you into the person that He wants you to be. If you're outside the body of Christ, please do what you need to do to become a member. Jesus, in Matthew chapter 11, in verse 28, He said, come unto me, all ye that labor and are heavy laden, I will give you rest. No matter what the world throws at us, no matter what it gives us, and all this garbage that we've seen the last couple of weeks, it don't matter, because God can give us rest. And Jesus said, take my yoke upon you and learn of me, for I'm meek and lowly in heart, and you shall find rest unto your souls. For my yoke is easy, my burden is light. If you're outside the body of Christ, come and be part of that body. Listen, my last thing is the invitation of Christ is never closed. I know we've kind of got used to in church services that there's a certain point in time that you sing an invitation song and people will come forward. But the invitation of Christ is open all the time. Find somebody that's a believer. Find somebody that knows God and talk to them. They'll be glad to help you and assist you in becoming a New Testament Christian. Again, thank you for being here. I'm going to have a closing prayer. Then we're going to have one more song. Kind of throws you off if you don't know what's coming, but we're going to have another song. And then after that, if you will come and have refreshments with us, we'd love to have you. Would you pray with me? Our Father, which art in heaven, hallowed be thy great and holy and good name, Father. Thank you, Father, for tonight. Thank you for the amount of people that have come together and the beautiful prayers that have been uttered. And Father, we know that you hear them. And we know, Father, that you know our hearts, that tonight we're prayerful for all of our school system, from the administrators down to the custodians and everybody in between and everybody that has anything to do with our kids. Father, we pray that those interactions that they have this year will be positive. We pray that they will be instructional. We pray, Father, that they will give our kids hope, because hope is something our world is missing so much of. We're thankful, Father, for your Son. We're thankful for what he did for us on the cross of Calvary. We're thankful for the death that he died. We're thankful for the burial he went through. But Lord, we're so thankful for the resurrection, that he came forth from the grave and he became our Savior, having overcome death, hell, and the grave. And we can follow him, and we know that we can have eternal home with you in heaven when this life is over. Father, tonight as we end this service, we're going to partake of some food. We pray that you bless that food to our bodies. Father, we pray that you would bless every person that's here. And we thank you so much, Father, for your Son. It's in his name we pray. Amen. Amen.
This one we add in one part each time we go around. So we start out with the altos, the lower women, then we add in the basses and the tenors, and finally the sopranos. And we like to sing this through twice once we have all four parts in there. Something else you may not have known you signed up for is usually when we sing the song, we like to hold hands. So if you don't mind, I invite you to join hands with whoever you're beside. Maybe somebody you don't know that well. That's okay. I promise you, there's worse things than holding hands with somebody for God. We can be uncomfortable about other stuff, but being uncomfortable for Jesus doesn't have to be a big deal.
He